Today is an Hitachi TRQ-134D 8-track recorder. Service belt, make sure it all works. Let's get on with it. Here it is, it's Hitachi TRQ-134D 8-track recorder. Fairly basic unit, headphones, microphone left and right, level meters, record level left and right, pause, record, continuous, auto stop, 1, 2, 3, 4. Auto stop 1, 2, 4, track or program, lights, program button, eject button, fast forward. Simple as that. Now looking at this, it's in lovely condition. Next to no scratches, hardly looks used. And I don't know if we can see in there, but the head looks brand new. I don't think it's ever really been used. So what we're going to do today is take the covers off, check the belts, because although it may not have been used, the belts could still be shot and probably are. So we'll change the belts, just give everything a cursory check over inside, give all the heads and the pinch rollers and everything a good clean, and hopefully it will work. So let's get on with it. So first things first, I've taken the screws out of this and pull this cover off the back. Show we have auxiliary in left and right, line out left and right, a record DIN socket and 215-230 volt switch. Doesn't say year on here. TRQ-134D, multi switcher 50-60 Hz, 70 watts. Right. See if it gives any clues inside. But you'll note with this construction, there's no screws on the side. No screws there. So you undo all these screws on the bottom and pull the whole chassis out. They're all out. Take them out of there as well. So now slide that off. So let's have a look in here. Do it on this cork board just so everything doesn't slide around. There we go. Actually, the belt doesn't look too bad, which is just as well because I haven't got one of those. That's a big old flat belt which I don't have, but actually it looks okay. Just yeah, that all looks alright. So we will just put it back on. It looked good. Now, all capacitors look good. Okay, I tell you what, this all looks alright. The grease is all All nice, it's not all horrible and congealed. Belt looks good. This honestly doesn't look like it's ever been used. I even quite like the construction, the removable plugs rather than everything soldered. It all honestly looks really good. The only downside we have, let's have a look. There's nothing on the motor to say the year, which is unfortunate. Generally, if you're going to find it, that's where you're going to find it. All the solder in there looks good. Looks okay. Over round to this side. Down side we've got is it doesn't look like the heads are that easy to get to, but I can get to them from this side, so that's okay. Not that they particularly look dirty or said even worn, but I will clean them just for the sake of cleaning them. So yeah, I think next stage we'll just get some IPA and give it all a clean. That's done. Now what I'm going to do is move them screws out of the way. As you can see, wherever it's gone, there, even though it looked pretty clean, you can see there's still a fair bit of dirt on there. That's mainly off the pinch roll, as the head was basically spotless. Just using a bit of isopropyl alcohol. But what I'm going to do before I put it back together is just make sure everything functions as it should, and then just give everything one final clean up before it all goes back together. But it's not connected to the amp, mainly because I haven't got a RCA cable long enough here at the moment, so you'll see that in a I'll edit it in later on. But first things first, let's plug this in. That's a good sign it hasn't blown up. We have, what have we got here, the Best of John Denver, Take Me Home Country Roads, Rhyme and Reasons, Goodbye Again, Stairwood in Aspen, The Eagle. Anyway, yeah, the reason I'm using this one is simply because it's got these different types of pads rather than the usual disintegrated pads. I haven't got around to fixing some of those. So let's put it in. Good sign. On track four. Track one. Track two. Track three, track four, track one, pause. Right, so that stopped at the end of track one there, so move it on to that one so it won't stop until the end of track four. Interestingly, we have not a lot happening on the VU meters. The right hand side is working, the left hand side isn't. That's... Oh, we've got a little bit of life on the left hand side. Alright, that's eject. Down the left hand side. Sorry, the right hand side is going. I don't know if you can see that there on the right hand side, but the left hand side is not moving. Tiny little flicker. Fast forward works. Pause works. Okay, right, well let's adjust that one. Let me try a different one, just to make sure it's not that. Okay, well let's try this one. Ah, there we go, we have... Again, the right hand side, left hand. Oh, the left hand side is starting to pick up, but not a lot. The right hand side is certainly more sensitive, so I think the head probably needs a bit of alignment. Try John Denver again. There we go, that's definitely a bit better. So I think the head just needs a touch of alignment there. So anyway, right, let's have a go at doing that. Right, so that's that for now. All works, the lights all work. Display lights up. Not 100% certain with the display, the VU meters. The left hand side doesn't really go up and down much, whereas the right hand side does. I've played about with the adjustments of the head, and that doesn't appear to be anything to do with it. So the head does seem aligned. So what I'm going to have to do, I think, for now, as far as I can, you know, it all works, it's all clean, blah blah blah, belt's good, etc. etc. Appears perhaps a little bit loose, but I might order another one. But for now, I'll put it all back together if, you know, it does work. And what I'm going to have to do is obviously see what the audio's like when it's actually plugged into the amp, see if I've got left hand and right hand audio properly. But also, I'm not sure how yet, but I want to see if I can get a test tone tape or cartridge. I've got one for the tape deck, as you'll see when I service the tape deck, which just gives an even tone, a 3 kHz tone across the board, which means I can check wow and flutter a tape speed, also check the VU meters are where they should be. I haven't found one for an 8-track yet, but I'll keep looking. Obviously it's pointless me making one on this unit, because if the left hand channel isn't right, well, it's going to record the same way. So for now, I'll put it back together and we'll come back to this at a later date. All that's left now really is just try the 8-track. So embrace the way the flowers in the wind. I think that's sounds pretty good, I think. Well, I do think we need a better light for the VU meters. Speed's good. Speed seems constant. Seems okay, it all seems to be coming out of both speakers well enough. Do think we need definitely a better light in that VU meter. I might have to modify that slightly, I think. Let's just try. That's interesting, I don't know if you can hear that. The tape head doesn't come away in fast forward, so it's now just going fast. Seems about double speed. I'll now try the auto stop, make sure that all works as it should. Where we are now. Is this the end, or have we got another track? Nope, that was the end. So yeah, it did stop after track four. Lights come on. So if we eject, cool. Again, it should now play from the start of track one. Or program one, track one. Oh, and Anna. Just for you, I know this is your favourite song. Almost heaven, West Virginia. Sod the copyright strike. We'll let this go. Oh. Life is older than the trees, younger than the mountains, growing like a breeze. Country roads. Take me home to the place I belong. West Virginia, mountain mama, take me home, country roads. Anna, don't switch off. I won't talk to you anymore. That all seems to be working lovely. And then we have a real treat for you. In the form of one of these. And if you've no idea what it is, keep watching for future videos when you'll find out. Ta-da!